Good evening, church. What a joy it is to welcome you into this annual celebration of our Lord's birth here on this Christmas Eve night. Indeed, it is unfortunate that we can't be together as we have been in the past. I, like you, remember last year, and in this space, us gathered together in the warmth of the candles and the sense of the sacredness of this sanctuary. And I want to invite you into that even now. Even as we can't be together, I hope that you will remember what we shared before and know that we will share it again, and that in that memory and in that hope, we can be present in it now. As we gather together for this worship, I want to say thank you to Jonathan, who continually makes this possible, breaking the barriers of time and space so that we can be together in this virtual worship. I want to thank my kids for being the choir tonight. It's really a blessing that they are willing to do that. And I want to thank Alcee, not only for his excellent musicianship on the organ, but for his capacity to turn my children into a choir for tonight. And so as we gather together in this sacred space, remembering the joy that we have received in the incarnate Lord, I want to invite you to take a moment and shut your eyes and remember what it is like to be in this sanctuary, and to sense what that feels like as we prepare ourselves for the worship that we are about to share with one another.
Thank you.
child is born.
O come, let us adore him. Alleluia.
Let us pray. O God, the Son, highest and holiest, purify our hearts, we pray, that we may be made worthy to worship you. Bring us with the shepherds and the wise men to kneel before your holy cradle, that we may sing with your angels your glorious praises in heaven, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God, world without end. Amen. To shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that we, who have known the mystery of that light on earth, may also enjoy him perfectly in heaven, where with you and the Holy Spirit he lives and reigns, one God in glory everlasting. Amen.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of the messenger who announces peace, who brings good news, who announces salvation, who says to Zion, your God reigns. Listen, your sentinels lift up their voices. Together they sing for joy. For in plain sight they see the return of the Lord to Zion. Break forth into singing, you ruins of Jerusalem. For the Lord has comforted his people. He has redeemed Jerusalem. The Lord has bared his holy arm before the eyes of all the nations, and all the ends of the earth shall see the salvation of our God. The word of the Lord.
Sing to remembers his mercy and faithfulness to the house of Israel. And all the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God.
Shout with joy to the Lord, all you lands. Lift up your voice, rejoice and sing. Sing to the Lord with the harp, with the pipe and the voice of song.
Let the sea make a noise and all that is in it, the lands and those who dwell therein.
Let the rivers clap their hands, then let the hills ring out with joy before the Lord when he comes to judge the earth. In righteousness shall he judge.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Long ago, God spoke to our ancestors in many and various ways by the prophets. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by a Son, whom he appointed heir of all things, through whom he also created the worlds. He is the reflection of God's glory and the exact imprint of God's very being. And he sustains all things by his powerful word. When he had made purification for sins, he sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high, having become as much superior to angels as the name he has inherited is more excellent than theirs. For to which of the angels did God ever say, "You are my son, today I have begotten you"? Or again, "I will be his father and he will be my son"? And again, when he brings the firstborn into the world, he says, "Let all God's angels worship him." Of the angels, he says, "He makes his angels winds and his servants flames of fire." But of the Son, he says, "Your throne, O God, is forever and ever, and the righteous scepter is the scepter of your kingdom. You have loved righteousness and hated wickedness. Therefore, God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of gladness beyond your companions. And in the beginning, Lord, you founded the earth, and the heavens are the work of your hands. They will perish, but you remain. They will all wear out like clothing. Like a cloak, you will roll them up, and like clothing, they will be changed. But you are the same. And your years will never end." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We have heard on high, singing sweetly through the night.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please be seated. The late Fred Rogers, most commonly known as Mr. Rogers of Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, was known for being able to speak with children about the truth in a way that did not diminish the truth nor diminish the child. I remember reading his wisdom about helping children through traumatic situations. He counseled his readers that if you were in a situation where a child saw something that was upsetting, like a car accident, or someone laying on the sidewalk, or someone injured or sick, draw their attention also to those that are helping. Help them notice, Mr. Rogers said, those that are around giving aid and attending to the broken. I find this wisdom so helpful as we come into the end of this 2020 year. We are so desperate for this year to be over and so hopeful for something new, something better, something restored. And I want to take a moment simply to acknowledge God's presence in all things, as Mr. Rogers taught us. In the incarnation, we remember that God comes among us, becomes one of us. Emmanuel means God with us. The prophets spoke about Emmanuel coming, and in Jesus, we see God's promise come to completion. To be incarnate is to be compassionate. It's a demonstration of our compassionate God. And the word compassion, when broken down, means co with passion being taken along. And so it is that God, in coming among us as compassion incarnate, allows God's self to be taken along into the reality of humanity, to come alongside of us, to come along with us into what it means to be human. And we know that in being human, we experience suffering. It is a reality of our humanity. And so it is that God comes among us, our compassionate God, and comes alongside us to suffer with us in the suffering that humanity most certainly endures. And in doing so, God shows us that he can redeem it, that suffering does not have the last word. And so I look back on this 2020 year to some particularities that had become so obvious to us so that we might see where God is in the midst of it. The first thing that comes to my mind about this year is poverty. For many of us, perhaps for all of us, we thought poverty was something that could be kept at bay, that if we just did everything right and followed the rules, that we would have what we need. This year has totally blown that apart. But we can remember that Jesus came in poverty. That poverty was not something that God shied away from, but that God entered into, born in a stable among the animals, not even with a room in the inn, but instead put into a space where there was only room. And it was in that space that God came among us, a part of a family of no fancy means, folks that worked for their living. This is what God knows. And so as we reflect on the poverty of our lives, the poverty that looms and poverty that's experienced by so many, we can remember that this is where Jesus is, that Jesus comes in a lowly state so that he can be with us there. Another thing that was so obvious to us in this 2020 year is oppression. We saw that in blatant demonstrations throughout this calendar year. And we can remember that God came among us as an oppressed person. The Jews in the Roman Empire were not ones that have privilege. They were not ones who were valued. And if you remember when Herod learned of this king's birth from the wise men that were traveling to see him, he felt threatened by the possibility that there might be anyone who would challenge his reign, challenge what he had established the way that he wanted it. And in doing the math, Herod determined that this child was probably somewhere under 2 years old. And what does he do? He has all the Hebrew boys that are 2 years old and younger killed. He sends his state into people's homes, taking those children and ending their lives. Yes, our Lord knows oppression. He knows what it means to be a part of a people that are not valued. And in coming among us, he reminds us that our value is because of him, that we are valuable because humanity is valued. He comes among us and reminds us that our value lies in his love for us, that he loves us so much that he comes into the world so that we might know that we are important, that we matter. All God's children matter, and that is what Jesus reminds us in coming into our lives. I'm also reminded this year of our vulnerability. This virus that has gone all around the world and continues to move reminds us that we cannot fully protect ourselves from the threats of being human, the threats of biology, the threats of creation. I don't know whether Jesus ever got a cold. I don't know if he ever stubbed his toe or scraped his knee or broke a bone. I don't know if Jesus ever got a virus, if he ever had pneumonia or the flu. We do not know that. But I do know that when Jesus hung on the cross and a sword pierced his side, that blood and water came from it, the very same substance from which we are made. And so it is that in becoming among us, coming among us incarnate, God shows us that our vulnerability is not something we need to fear, that God can redeem all things, that God values us and can bring us into new life. This is what God reminds us of in the incarnation. And so as we reflect on this year, on the poverty that we have seen, on the oppression that we have seen, on the vulnerability that we have seen, and some of us have experienced that poverty intimately, or that oppression intimately, or that vulnerability intimately, in each of these occasions, we can remember that God comes among us in the poverty, in the oppression, in the vulnerability, and does not leave us there. Where are are you, Lord, in this? I am in the midst of you, God says. And I will redeem this year. I will redeem what has happened. I will make something good come from all of this. You will be transformed by my love, God says. For my love is patient and steadfast. My love is kind and compassionate. My love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude, because it does not insist on its own way. Instead, God says, I ask for your consent to my love. I ask for you to receive it. God's love is not irritable or resentful, but is merciful and just. God does not rejoice in revenge or wrongdoing. Instead, God is the joy that is truth, the truth that transforms and redeems. God's love bears all that humanity bears. God's love believes in the capacity of humanity to do good. God hopes in humanity's possibility to endure the feebleness of ourselves and to live instead into the good in which we were created, the good that we were created to be and to do. This is the love that never fails. This is the love that came down at Christmas. The love, all lovely, love divine. This was the love that was born at Christmas that changes the world by coming among us. Yes, my friends, in the poverty and the oppression and the vulnerability that Jesus knew, he came among us to rescue us from the poverty and the oppression and the vulnerability that any of us know, changing it into something good, bringing us into new life. Thus, he says to us when the angels proclaim in glory, do not be afraid, for behold, I make all things new. I have done it before, and I will do it again. Amen. I invite you now to stand as we affirm our faith and say together the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Father, in this holy night, your Son, our Savior, was born in human form. Renew your church as the body of Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, Christians the world over are celebrating his birth. Open our hearts that he may be born in us today. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, there was no room for your Son in the inn. Protect with your love those who have no home and all who live in poverty. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, Mary, in the pain of labor, brought your Son to birth. Hold in your hand all who are in pain or distress today. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, your Christ came as a light shining in the darkness. Bring comfort to all who suffer in the sadness of our world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, shepherds in the field heard good tidings of joy. Give us grace to preach the gospel of Christ's redemption. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, the angels sang, peace to God's people on earth. Strengthen those who work for peace and justice in all the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, strangers found the Holy Family and saw the baby laying in a manger. Bless our homes and all whom we love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, heaven is come down to earth, and earth is raised to heaven. Keep in safety all those who have gone through death in the hope of heaven. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this holy night, angels and shepherds worshiped at the manger throne. Receive the worship we offer in fellowship with Blessed Mary and all the saints. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Unto us a child is born, the Prince of Peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
I invite you to turn and share a sign of God's peace. I want to thank those who have made this service possible with their pre-recordings. For all of our choir members and their participation in our virtual choir tonight, for Amy who read the scriptures, and for Lori who led us in the prayers, thank you each one. And I want to thank you for your gifts and your support of the ministry we carry out together as St. Stephen's Church. This year has been unexpected in so many ways, and your support has made it possible for us to adapt and to adjust as needed to what the world needs in these particular times. And we move forward in faith, trusting that you will continue to support the ministry that we carry out together. And so I invite you to give in the ways in which you're familiar, or if this is something you haven't done before, you may give through our text number, which you'll see right there on the screen. And I thank you for your support of our ministry, because together we are the hands and feet of Christ in this world. For God has no hands on this earth but ours, no feet on this earth but ours. It's only our eyes with which God can look compassion onto the world. So thank you for your support. And here, as we bring our offerings together in, to be blessed by God for his service, hear the words of Scripture. Ascribe to the Lord the honor due his name. Bring offering and come into his courts.
Ding dong merrily on high, in heaven the bells are ringing. Ding dong merrily the sky is riddled with angels singing. Steeple bells be swung, and dee-o-ee-o-ee-o.
Hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because you gave Jesus Christ, your only Son, to be born for us, who by the mighty power of the Holy Spirit was made perfect man of the flesh of the Virgin Mary, his mother, so that we might be delivered from the bondage of sin and receive power to become your children. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death. We proclaim his resurrection. We await his coming in glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, where with Stephen and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Alleluia, Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the peace. Alleluia.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Let us pray. God of love and grace, of justice and peace, we give you thanks that in the sacrament of the altar, you assure us of your presence within us and within the body of Christ, the faithful through all the generations. Grant that we who have witnessed anew these holy mysteries, though unable to receive the physical elements of the sacrament, may be moved by your indwelling spirit ever more fully to embody your holy and life-giving presence, reshaping in your likeness the world around us until we are gathered at last into the fullness of your glorious and eternal presence. Through Christ our risen Lord. Amen. May the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you now and always. Amen.
Thank you.
Christ is the light of the world. Go in the name of Christ to bring his light to others. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.